to Club G's Fitness Review. I'm your host, Katherine Maloney, one of the personal trainers at Club Genentech. Today we will be looking at and dissecting Matt Cain's perfect game. So for those of you who don't know him, he was one of San Francisco Giants' starting pitchers. And on June 13, 2012, he stepped up on the mound and made history. He was the 22nd pitcher in Major League Baseball to throw a perfect game and the first ever in Giants franchise history. Let's take a look at his accomplishments and what we can take away from his hard work and success. All right, first and foremost, if you'd like to check out highlights from the game itself, I've attached the link in the description below for you guys to check out either now or after the video, but it's a great feel-good, emotional roller coaster, makes you miss baseball type of video. So go check it out, highly recommend. So going into the fitness review itself, I want to look at three different components that ultimately led Matt Cain to his success that very day. And then what we can take away from his hard work. So let's first look at strength and conditioning. So just like you and me, he was in a gym, he was working on compound movements such as squats and deadlifts to build up his leg strength. He was working on core and stability work. He was working on shoulder mobility work to make sure that when he threw the ball, he was pain-free. He really didn't do anything crazy. It was following a program, staying on the program. He was held accountable for his workouts, making sure that he was diligent in the gym, that he was committed to the process. And just like you and me, we can easily get discouraged. But you know what? If you have that goal, if you have something that you're working towards, you just do it. You just show up for yourself. You get behind the bar. You crank out those sets, those reps, whatever you need to do to accomplish your goal. And that's exactly what he had to do. Maybe some days were mundane, but you know what? It all paid off. So that's a big portion of behind the scenes work that Matt Cain did. Another one is mind-body connection. So really being able to connect the two. So they always talk about, you know, proprioception and where your body is in space. And I think that's a huge concept for pitchers because he has to know where that ball is going. He, from the release point, he has to know whether or not he's gonna throw a strike, a ball, and that is working on proprioception. So really being able to decrease endpoint variability and making sure he knows that every time he throws the ball to Buster Posey that it's going to be a strike. And that was obviously evident when he struck out over half the batters that he faced. And it just proves that mind-body connection is huge. Your body will do what your mind says. And don't ever underestimate that. So if you tell yourself, I can do this, I can do this, I can do this, guess what? You will be able to do it. Trust the process, make that mind-body connection. And the third thing that was a big takeaway is teamwork. Really making sure that you can work with a team, whether that be on a project, whether that be with a group exercise instructor, whether that be with a trainer, that you have somebody on your side, somebody there to support you, somebody there that can really help you when you ask for help. And I think the whole thing behind Matt Cain's perfect game was he trusted Buster Posey. Buster Posey was a huge component to his success. He had to rely on his calls. He had to trust that when he told him to throw a fastball, that was going to be the right move. And sometimes just letting yourself surrender to someone else can really be a cool thing. So don't ever be afraid to ask for help. Don't ever be afraid to rely on somebody else, because it can lead to great things. And I think that's the coolest part of this whole game, was it was a team effort. That it was, yeah, of course Matt Cain got recognition for it, but it was a team effort, and none of that could have happened if they all didn't trust each other. They had to be there for each other, even though they were all doing their own individual work for their own positions. It all mattered in that one moment. So I think that's really cool, just to see how much even just relying on one person, or not even relying, but kind of, you know, helping out somebody else can make an impact on their life. So I think those are three big things that went on kind of behind the scenes, but then also was very evident when watching it back. What are three takeaways that we can learn from Matt Cain's hard work and success? The first one being is mental toughness. So making sure that you can stay strong under pressure. We've all had moments where, you know, we're working out, we're at that last set, we don't want to do it, and you know what? More times than not, we do it. And that's training your mental game. So be proud of those little victories, even though it might not have been your best workout. You stayed strong, you stayed with it, and you probably felt a lot better after the workout. So be proud of yourself on that, but keep the mental game strong, keep it up. Second is this whole concept of exercise versus training. So we can all go into a gym, work out for 30 minutes on a treadmill, sweat it out, feels great, and there's nothing wrong with that. But trying to recognize that you could take your exercise up another notch and train. Do you have a goal? Do you have a program that you're on? Is there something that you're working towards? Because that's gonna separate you from exercising versus training. So step up that game. We are here to help. If you need to get on a program, if you need some guidance, us trainers, we are more than willing to help. We love doing this. This is what we do for a living. We want to take your exercise to that training level, and it's amazing what can happen when you do that. So get tough, bring your mental game into this and step up that exercise to a training level, and you'll see just how many results can come from that. This third takeaway is this concept of staircase versus elevator. So we all have goals. We would obviously rather have them achieved sooner rather than later, but the reality is we have to work for them. And I can tell you this, that all the hard work that Matt Cain put into his in-season training, his off-season training, made that moment in history so much sweeter. So remember that there's always an easy way out, but you don't want to take that way. Take the stairs. The elevator can wait. We can work hard. Just get your mind tough, take those stairs, and train. You got this. I promise you, it will pay off. Matt Cain showed it did, and I'm just here to reiterate that you can do it, and us trainers are here for you, and we miss you guys, and stay tuned for next week. More fitness review coming your way. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and go Giants! Are you ready for living?